believe that in order to reach salvation, individuals must free themselves of selfish desires that separate humans from Brahman. Only when they have done this can they achieve oneness of the soul with Brahman. Union with Brahman is the ultimate goal of Hinduism and is known as moksha. Most people cannot achieve moksha in only one lifetime. Therefore, they will continue to be reborn in different bodies until they do. Reincarnation allows the soul to continue on its mission to moksha. As in all religions, different people practice Hinduism differently, according to their own needs and beliefs. The Dude Baba is a Hindu teacher and holy man who lives among the Pashupati temples of Nepal's capital, Kathmandu. He has dedicated his life to his practice of Hinduism.
The Baba took up the ascetic life and forsook all possessions when he was 18 years old. Since then, he has traveled on many pilgrimages to many different holy places. But 13 years ago, he settled down in this ashram here in Pashupati. This is where he lives. This is where he teaches. For the last 13 years, the Baba has lived in this ashram. This form of prayer is called mantra. During mantra, the Baba will repeat a single prayer. And every time he repeats the prayer, he'll rub one of the beads. The ring of beads is known as the mala. And the Baba will repeat his prayer as he goes around the mala. I asked the Baba how many times he repeats his prayer. He explained that every day he repeats his prayer 6,000 times as he rubs the bead. The Baba is playing an instrument called a harmonium. As he plays the harmonium, he's singing words from the Hindu holy book. He's singing the scriptures. The Baba believes that the five senses are the doorway to the mind and ultimately to spirituality. He believes that if you can control the senses, then you will also be able to control the mind. And in controlling the mind, you'll have only wholesome thoughts. He believes that through this discipline, you can attain a higher state of spirituality. Fifteen years ago, the Baba stopped consuming all forms of solid food. His only source of nutrition over these last 15 years has been milk. Baba hasn't consumed a morsel of food in 15 years. He explained to me that none of his gurus, none of his mentors told him to do this or asked him to do this, that he made his own decision, to consume only milk. He chose milk because it's pure, and because it'll provide him with spiritual energy. He boils the milk and drinks 3 or 4 cups a day. Other than the milk, he consumes no food. Since he drinks only milk, he's known all over Nepal as the Milk Baba. Now the Nepali word for milk is dude. So when people come to his ashram, they address him and they say, Dude Baba.
Hinduism, like all religions, is difficult to explain, but it has many parallels to other belief systems. From the beginning of life to the end, Hinduism influences how its followers live, and now we have had a chance to learn about this unique and vibrant religion as well.
घर आया मैं आया तुझको लेने।